I will focus on my speech on two matters. One is the collection of revenue. All these taxes, when it goes up, take for instance the cigarette. The taxes legally collected and illegally coming to the country is almost double. Why can't some preventive measures are taken to stop this leakage? If two containers are detained or even discovered at whatever the point, 20 containers come. If you see the tobacco company annual report, you see how much of money is not collected from one industry. Then they are mentioned about ARAC, since we are involved in this industry. There are only 1,100 licenses in the whole of this island. Out of these 1,100, 500 is controlled by three people. 500 is controlled by three individuals. They have bought the licenses. So much so, the first time in the world, that some genuine licensees have taken the government to task and filed a case in district court compelling the government revenue department to enforce law and order. They estimate 80 billion rupees lost in revenue for 1 year. I fully agree with them. I mean, they are the people who sell. And they know the amount of illegal, unpaid, taxpaid alcohol is sold in the market. What is the use of doing this and giving concessions? You have 80 billion from one industry. You have another 20 or 30 billion from another industry. What steps have you taken to collect? Minister of Finance has made a wonderful budget, given a lot of relief, a lot of attention, under difficult and different circumstances. But unfortunately, the advisors to him has not focused how to bridge this or find this one from locally, which is available. Today, salmon is imported to this country for 500 rupees, maximum 750 rupees. Kobe beef is imported at 1,000 rupees. Australian beef, New Zealand beef is 600 rupees. How much of millions you have lost? Who is the benefactor, including this hotel? The people who come to here to eat and dine and wine. How many such people can afford to come here? These are practicalities. Nobody is looking into these practicalities. I'm sure if you enforce the rule of law, if you police these three departments, Inland Revenue, Customs and Excise, doctor said the customs ordinance to be changed after 100 years, I believe. Same with excise laws. You have to change. Entire North and East is not police. Recently, STF, you all have seen in the papers, they have raided a massive racket. Who is interfering? The Assistant Commissioner of Excise in the district. North and East district is saying, don't persecute, release this group. So that shows, I told about 2-3 weeks ago, the excise commissioner interdict this fellow and take him to task. Up to now, nothing has happened. Now they are trying to introduce a sticker. First, they must find out how this alcohol is made. They must come to our factories and see what is automation, whether this can be practically manually done. My machines are running, also the beer company, 35,000, 40,000. Bottles per hour. How can you place one sticker in this? These are all automation, and the moment that you lift the bottle from the line, stickers are broken. They don't go into this, however much you say. I saw in the newspapers the other day, I don't know, I'm the union of the railway is right. They have imported locomotives from the Indian line of credit. The track can take only, say, 100 kilometers speed, and the weight, 150 kilos. The engine is more than that. So you have to relay the track, completely run these engines. So there's a tussle between the union and the railway department. So these are silly mistakes that is costing the government billions. See the amount of corporations we have in this country. How many corporations are making money? How many are subsidized? I think if you stop this corruption and waste, we don't need money from outside, as this money is available. The food imports, only 5 people are getting enriched. So for this food to import that and sell that and declare these prices, they have to buy black market dollars or pounds or euros. So the black market thrives. And that money is artificially high. So these are areas, not the increasing of taxes or the areas of going into the various sectors. If you put your house into order, if you get the correct advice from the people who are in the industry, how to collect these funds, it is simple. You don't have to run around. You don't have to get this chart and do all kinds of things. It's nonsense. This is simple income and revenue. All these charts are merely academic. It has no relevance to what the current situation is. Look at agriculture today. Yesterday's TV showed Paddy at 35. You are given free fertilizer to the farmers. Next year will be bumper crop. Where are they going to sell? He will be discouraged. No one prioritizes. If they advise family, either find an export market. There are so many ways of doing it. Doesn't Vietnam export rice? Doesn't Pakistan export rice? Their farmers are benefited. Under the schemes that US has introduced, all the farmers are protected. Under the DEIP scheme, this scheme, that scheme. If there is moon cultivation, there is always thereby stockpiling. Correct me if I'm wrong. So they have a policy. Here, onion harvest is high. At that time, we start importing onions. They don't ban. By the time we take action, half the crop is spoiled. Now see what pumpkins, what is happening? Bumper crops can't sell. No storage. These are perishables. So these are things matters they should address these issues. No mind of saying I'm increasing taxes, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. Enforcement. Can you buy dog meat even at 500 rupees? Who is 5 people? Luxury life. Non-nationals. What is happening to poor farmers and poor people in the countryside? Their crop is affected by weather, affected by wildlife. And with the little produce that they harvest can't sell. How can you go on the system? Every day you see the TV, how many houses are broken, how many people are killed. They are putting fences halfway erected, they are falling down. So enforce the rule of law. And then the Minister of Finance job will be much easier. Whatever the right or wrong, we have borrowed money, we have to pay. We have to pay the interest. Whether they are productive or unproductive is a matter for the next government or the future generation. But these are blunders that we have made. So now we have to overcome. We can't destroy the port. We can't destroy the airport. Now we have phosphate, enough and more. We import fertilizer. It's crazy. Why there's a demonstration? They won't allow us to mine phosphate. But we import. Milk, 70,000 to 80,000 tons imported. Work it out at $3,500 a ton, how much the foreign exchange is doing? We imported cows. The cows are sick. Half them are dead. So who is responsible? The taxpayer is paying. Public is paying. So these are things that can be done locally. So there is no rocket science or magic or pundits you need to do this kind of thing. We don't need professors to come and advise. Go to the farmer and ask, why can't you have your cow? We have bought diseased cows. The certificates are not given. So these are blunders we make. So these are the areas, I think, if the minister gives much more attention to this waste and corruption, these corporations that are not performing for the last 20, 30 years, being paid subsidies, close down. Look at other countries. Unfortunately, we are not learning the lesson. We are continuing with the same mistake and continuing with the same style of operation and taxing. Out of 22 million people we have, I was told today, this morning, only 125,000 files. Am I right or wrong? It's laughable. The other day, the Prime Minister had a meeting, and somebody was telling, raising that issue, and telling to go to Royal College and see the number of cars that are coming in. Go to St. Thomas College, see the number of luxury cars that are coming in. That is true. How can this 125,000 files, and then these 125,000 poor taxpayers are harassed from morning till evening? Whenever you open the mail, about red notices for payments made also. So how, this is how this place is run. Since there are so many other people, if I take all your time, I think it should be 12, we have to go. Thank you very much. If anybody wants to clarify what I have said, please. I am ready to answer any question of what I said is incorrect, or anybody wants to clarify, please ask me. Because I'm a practical man, I'm involved in the industry. I do the same. So I know this side and I know the other side of the coin. Thank you very much for your kind hearing.